Frank here with the one, the only, Ihsahn. As soon as you listen to Amr, the new record, it's really apparent right away that it's an Ihsahn record.
And, thank you.
And you know, it sounds like you, and that's so hard to do, you know, like to have such a unique style that can be picked up just from hearing a couple of notes and your voice. You know, how do you go about finding individuality in a time where that's really hard to do?
Well, to be honest, I think I tried to almost go all the way around. Because I've been doing this for such a long time now that every time I start an album, I try to find an angle that I've never done before, you know, or at least elements of how I write and produce it will be fundamentally different, just to keep it really exciting, you know,
for
me, yeah. And also, I guess, it's a limit to how confident you get. You know, even though you do a lot of records, you still feel like you're kind of getting away with it, and maybe every time, you always start anew. You know, with a new record, you feel like, you know, there's just empty space in front of you. But then again, over the years, I think I've learned to trust that even though I do things in a very different way, eventually it usually ends up sounding like me. You know, because I guess there are certain elements of how I do things, you know, the singing style and maybe how I phrase my riffs and everything that might be repetitive. Or
right. Well, I don't find it repetitive. I just think it's very you, you know.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate that. I mean, it's on the one side, you don't want to be kind of repeating yourself as much as you want to challenge yourself and do something fresh. But at the same time, it's always admirable in other artists, you know, not talking about myself here, but like, say, Radiohead, mm-hmm. who could do OK Computer or Kid A and still sound like Radiohead.
Right.
So
yeah,
that's to me, that's kind of an ideal. Or David Bowie, for that matter, you know, who could just journey through genres and expressions, but still with integrity of sounding like David Bowie.
To that note, last time we talked, I remember you said that, you know, you find inspiration in a lot of different places, a lot of different landscapes, and you even go as far as listening to pop sometimes because it's sonically very different than what you do.
Mm-hmm.
What would you say is some really off-the-wall inspirational stuff that you found for Amr?
I guess the use of like tuned 808s,
okay.
You know, from typical more modern R&B hip-hop style productions, and like really heavy, you know, this sub-bass.
Wow.
Things and the scenery is always different. I like with Arctis, you know, the scenery was obviously outside. It was in this Arctic landscape, and the lyrics and everything kind of lend images from that scenery. For this new one, as the cover artwork also suggests, it was very clear to me that I wanted an album that happened inside. Not inside somewhere special. I think my notes read something like inside a room with no walls, kind of very dark, but still kind of intimate place. So then I wanted to change out all the more kind of bright, open, big sounds of, say, strings or more orchestral sounds that I've kind of went for in the past. And with more focus on analog synthesis, and to also underline, you know, sonically, the more intimacy of the atmosphere I was going for.
You always have like a slew of great people to work with, you know, usually in your band and everything. How much input do they ever have on an Ihsahn record?
Apart from Tobias Ernest, who's doing the drums, none of them really have any input.
Right. But does Tobias like write with you or?
No. I present the record and I tell him what to play. But of course with an openness for interpretation because he's a fabulous drummer. I am
yeah,
not.
Yeah, yeah.
So I leave it open for him to interpret and kind of do things that I would never think about. But everything else I just play and produce myself. But as you say, when it comes to the live, performance, I definitely try to leave, some room for, I never, go through what kind of the sounds the guitar player will use. I leave that open for a bit of interpretation. And everyone will kind of bring a different flavor, to what it sounds like, which kind of keeps it a bit fresh for me as well.
Right. Yeah, that's awesome.
But in the studio, it's a very self-indulgent, egocentric kind of thing. So the only one who actually really have any input on the creative process in that regard is my wife, Heidi, who's also a musician and kind of my secret.
I heard that you send like files to her every time you write something cool, and maybe check it out with her.
Absolutely. So it's very important to have someone you trust who can kind of give that honest feedback, and she knows me so well. But she also has this kind of way of objectivity that she kind of knows where I'm kind of peaking and when I can do better. And she will tell me. But the same when she's been producing, like, a lot of the records from Leopard, she's been producing all the vocals with Einar, and because he also, he knows that she will push him to his maximum, but also stop him when he's going too far, she's kind of a natural born producer in that sense.
Speaking of vocals, I wanted to actually take a moment to talk about your vocals on this album, because they have just come leaps and bounds ahead. I mean, from where you started, I mean, going back to like Emperor's Thus Spake the Night Spirit, and like when you open up and have those clean vocals and everybody gets chills all the way, 20 years later, you're doing some amazing work,
Thank you, vocally. I appreciate that.
And I wanted to know if you spend maybe more time doing that than practicing guitar at this point.
It's hard to say, really. It's all very intuitive, and I probably should be more consistent in kind of doing, regular training or, both guitar and vocals. But it's also guitar playing. I've never been, when I was a kid, I played for hours and hours and hours, but not constructively, today I'm going through all the Titanic modes and speed them up with the tempo maps or whatever. I've always only played as a necessity to create.
Right.
And the same with vocals as well. I just tend to try and sing the stuff that I want the song to have. My black metal vocals, those shrieky vocals, is something that I'm pretty confident about. So that will usually be just like one or two takes. When I have the lyrics and I have the rhythm and the divisions, that will be more of a performance. But I kind of lack that confidence with my clean singing. Like most people, I too have a very estranged, relationship to my regular voice.
Right.
Most people kind of hate,
of course, yeah,
the sound of their recorded voices, regardless.
Yeah.
So it's kind of the same with vocals. Maybe that's why I tend to do a lot of backing vocals and layerings, and there are very few parts that are just, mellow.
We're here at Heavy Montreal 2018. You're playing with Emperor tonight, and I saw you. Of course, we met up last year at Hellfest, and you were celebrating 20 years of Anthems. And I figured that might have been the end, for celebrating and doing stuff with Emperor for a while. But here we are. Do you have anything in store for the future of Emperor? Are you going to continue this and for the rest of the year?
No, this is just. It's such a privileged position to be in. That for all these kind of reunion or celebration things that we've been doing, it's just we get to kind of cherry pick, these wonderful festivals to play, and we're lucky to have so many people kind of dedicated to do you want to see it and everything?
I was actually going to ask if it's hard to make a record like Amr and then get on stage to do it.
No, not at all, because I think making a record is, you know, it's one thing, but playing live is a totally different thing. To be honest, in that kind of live bubble, that kind of interaction with live music and the audience and everything, strangely, it feels very much the same whether I play with Emperor or with Ihsahn. It's just performing those songs, kind of channeling the energy that kind of lay in them. So that is more of a state of mind. Of course, it varies because it's kind of different things, but I've never really felt any difference.
Right.
Again, with the difference, you know, with prioritizing, and I mean, I play a very extreme form of music.
Yeah.
You know, and I come from Norway, and still I get to do both. You know, there's not really much to complain about.
No, it's true. Yeah. It's true. It's amazing. So there's nothing on the horizon for Emperor going forward from this, right?
No, it all depends. I mean, in the past we've said like, this is the absolute last show and what have you, but. We have no immediate plans beyond what we've scheduled. We're playing not next week, but the week after we do Partisan, and then we kind of end off in at Bloodstock in the UK and play special guest for Judas Priest. A nice kind of ending of that chapter.
Oh,
then
absolutely.
Then we'll see.
Yeah. And but the Equilibrium reunion for that.
I think we've done Eclipse now and Anthems, so I think. If we were to do anything again, it would probably be, you know, something different.
That said, if you haven't heard it yet, Amr, the new record from Ihsahn, it is a beautiful, beautiful record, one of my favorite of the year. Pick it up in stores everywhere right now.
Thank you.